and welcome to our reaction to Queen. And we are going to react to the song Tenement Funster. This is our first time single take on this reaction to this song by Queen. Let's get started.
Funster, like a youngster.
Funster. Tenement Funster.
Tenement is like an apartment complex.
Yeah.
Tiny ones.
Yeah, small ones.
My new purple shoes, been amazing to people next door. And my rock and roll 45, been enraging the folks on the lower floor. Got away with the girls on my block, trying my best to be a real individual. And when we go down to Smokies and Rock, they line up like it's some kind of ritual. Ooh, give me a good guitar.
It definitely wasn't Freddie Mercury. Didn't sound like Freddie Mercury to me at all. But anyway, great song. Reminded me a lot of Led Zeppelin, in fact.
Okay.
The way it was constructed, the way the vocals sounded.
Hmm.
Oh, I must get a new set of headphones if this was Freddie Mercury. This was good. It sounded good. Message is loud and clear that he wants to just get out of this place. Wow, this seems like the inspiration for Fast Car in a way. Little bit of an inspiration for Fast Car of Tracy Chapman.
Ah.
Don't know which came first. Anyway, this was good. This was good. All of the things that we want. We have such big dreams. We have such great aspirations, goals, call it what you will. But sometimes we don't have the money or we just can't do it. We just don't have the contacts. We just don't have the way around things. Like some few people seem to do. They always seem to get their way around things.
I like three lines the best. When you're young and you're poor and you're crazy. This combination is really, really dangerous. He's young and he's poor. He knows that. But he's crazy. He wants to make it. He's heavily into music. He wants to do something. He wants to get out of there. He likes good things. And those good things aren't free. And, you know, it's between your passion, it's between your desires and what you have in reality. whether inspiration or not from, you know, different places, but this was kind of a story of two decades or so, when rock music was, like, you know, dominating as a religion in the West, and a lot of young people wanted to be part of that, not just as a listener, but as a musician, as a contributor. And so many of them were talented, but they could not get through.
Yeah, it's so sad what is happening to rock music, even heavy metal music.
Yeah.
There's no one really big come on the scene for more than 22 years, I think. 20 plus years at least. I think it's dying, at least the legends, they are all dying. Many of them are already dead. And the music lives on for sure, but no one new is coming on the scene. So it's sad. I don't know how it happened, but it's not relevant to the song at least. But yes, I connect with the lyrics of the song completely. I like the way it was sung.
I like the way the drums also played.
Judging by one of those screenshots which showed Brian May at the mic, I'm assuming he is the one who sang it. But I don't think this is Freddie Mercury.
I think a little bit of it, maybe. I thought it was Freddie Mercury singing most of it. Yeah,
okay.
Most of it.
Okay, I need to get new headphones.
You must, listen to it one more time, maybe.
Yeah, that's it for this one. Enjoyed it, and we know the message, and it's definitely relevant. Even in today's world.